Don't forget to subscribe to Guiding Tech and also tap on the bell icon to never miss a video from us.
Hello friends, what's up? Welcome back to Guiding Tech, and in this video, I'll be talking about the 15 new apps for this month. Yes, for the May 2017. And in this video, we'll be discussing about 8 apps and 7 games. So well, what are we waiting for? Let's get started and have a look. So let's start with something easy, and the name of the app is MyWalls. So it is basically a wallpaper app for Android and has a jaw-dropping collection of high-resolution backdrops and wallpapers. This app curates the best wallpapers from Unsplash, and what's more is that the collection is refreshed every day or two. The app is free on the Play Store, however, you can choose to make a donation to support the developer. Moving on, we have Lookup. That's a pop-up dictionary on number 2, and it's a dictionary meant for offline use, which is actually its biggest plus point. Now all you need to do is select a word, tap on the 3 dots menu, and again tap on the lookup button. Bam! The literal meaning of the word will be displayed right away, along with the pronunciation as well. The database is huge and contains the meaning of up to 2.2 lakh words and phrases. The super annoying habit of your traveling companion can be quickly fixed through this app, which goes by the name of Privacy Screen Guard and Filter. Now, this app overlays a dark screen over your display with only a tiny inch of the screen visible, and handling this app is super simple. What's more is, if you think that your neighbor isn't getting the message, you can even darken the screen more, and looking at the phone's viewing app angles, he'll not be able to read anything from it. InstaSwipe is up next for Instagrammers who need to share panoramas in style. Now this particular app beautifully divides panoramas into equal grids and uploads it onto Instagram. And yet, when you look at the uploaded content, it appears to be a beautifully and seamlessly integrated to form a panorama mode, and you just need to swipe from right to left to look at the photos, and even the resolution is intact. Now if you think about it, doing it manually will take so much of time, but this app makes it look like a walk in the park. Surely we all know that a bright screen in dark environment or a dark screen in a well-lit room can be a perfect recipe for eye strain. The built-in night mode can help you in such scenarios, but what if you want to lower the brightness even more than the system allowed threshold? Night screen is at number 5, and this is the app that's going to answer the above question. This app creates an overlay on top of your screen, and in the process, it shields your eyes from the offending light. Overall, it's a simple to use app, which is actually you should be using like right now. Cursor Control is up next, and it can take away annoyance while editing large amount of text on Android. While editing, the cursor always tends to land in all the places but the place of your choice. Though keyboards like Gboard and SwiftKey have the answer to it, but then not everyone uses those apps. And if you are among those users, you can say hi to Cursor Control. Now using this app, you can choose to move cursor using the volume button, and you can actually use it on specific apps or all the apps out there. And what's best part is it only works when you're actually on a text box, and like when you're listening to music, you can always use the volume rockers to control your volume. Pixbar Energy Bar is at number 7, and it's another customization app for your phone. It creates an overlay at the top of the screen to show the progress of the decline of the battery juice or Wi-Fi signal. You can choose to have an indicator too along the pixel line display. Pocket Sense is at number 8, and it's kind of a security app with unique functionalities. As the name suggests, it will make sense of its surrounding when it's in your pocket, and if by any chance it's lifted out, it will sound an alarm. This app makes sure that the phone's accelerometer to catch the thief is always on. It also features a charge sense mode, which will sound an alarm when the phone is removed for charging station. This is actually useful for the crowded places, like the public places where you use your phone as a charging point, or you're just not sure if anybody would want to pickpocket to take your phone. So those were the 8 best apps that you can install this month. Now let's move on to the gaming part. So starting with Nonstop Chuck Norris, and as the name suggests, it's a game based on the on-screen ethics and legends of Hollywood superstar Chuck Norris. the game developers have rightly said it. Everything is a weapon when you're Chuck Norris. You can expect a lot of action in this game as you battle out infinite villains, as Chuck Norris is in the endeavor to save multiple universes. The game is free to play with some in-app purchases which can be turned off easily, and it runs without an internet connection. Moving on, my personal favorite in the list, Age of Empires Castle Seas, is the mobile version of the most popular strategy games ever. This game title was awaited by a lot many, and Microsoft has finally brought the acclaimed strategy game to the handheld devices. The game is set in the medieval era, and like the PC edition, you can choose from several civilizations, train troops, defend your city, and fight battles while researching new techniques. Next, we have Transformers Forged to Fight, and this is based on the popular Transformers movie franchise, and players get to control their favorite Autobots, Decepticons, and so much more. The action fighting RPG games let you play as Optimus Prime, Bumblebee, Megatron, Soundwave, and other several Transformers that we have been watching in movies for so long. Next is Bahubali, and the game has garnered an insane response from the audience, and the recently released second part of the movie is rising the chart of top grossing movies from India. It's a strategy game, by the way, and it resembles so much like the Clash of Clans, wherein you need to build up your defense in order to ascertain that your fort doesn't fall to enemy attacks. You need to train your troops, defend your fort, attack the enemies with heroes such as Bahubali, Katappa, and more. You can also battle your players, make clans with friends to battle over clans worldwide. Moving on, CATS, which also stands for Crash Arena Turbo Star, is up next, and it's another fighting game on the list which players need to assemble their war machine and collect part, design it, and then battle it with other players. You'll need to design, craft, and upgrade your battle robot to come fight other players in a P versus P, that's also called as player versus player action. Enter your battle ready bot into the world championship and battle hundreds of other customized robots to become the ultimate champion. Up next is Power Rangers Legacy Wars, and is based upon the popular franchise which goes by the same name. Players will here need to defeat Rita, who has cloned Power Rangers and making them fight for her. Defeat Rita and save the Morphin Grid. Well, that's about the game. You can also engage in real player versus player battle against players globally in famous location from movies and TV shows. Players will have 40 plus warriors to choose from, and they include both rangers and villains from the Power Rangers multiverse in this high graphic game. Finally, the last one in the list is Chicken Scream, and it's a platformer game, but an unusual one. The chicken needs to keep walking to complete the level and jump in order to avoid falling down. The unusual part here is that you are going to control the chicken using your voice. Yes, you heard it right. You'll have to talk or sing to make the chicken walk and scream to make it jump and let it pass the obstacles. And yes, you are right. There's no tapping involved while playing this game, at least in this stage. But there are so many other levels where you can actually control the chicken using the on-screen controls. But this is what makes the game a chicken scream, isn't it? So friends, those were the best 15 apps and games of the month. Now if you think that we have left out any of the good ones, please do mention them in the comment section, and we'll try to include them in our next month's video. Well, if you like this one, please do give us a thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed to our channel, do hit that red subscribe button, and until next time, take care and have a wonderful day. Bye bye.